Happy Wednesday, people. Hey, it's Pop Trigger time. Hey. And it's like, it's the intimate version of Pop Trigger, Grace, and everyone, Will Neff, in the hot seat today. Hey, buddy, how's it going?
Hi there.
Yes, happy to be here today. It feels, today's like a very somber June gloom kind of.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, Wednesday. I came in hot this morning. I had major attitude,
road rage. You're fired up.
Yes, fired up, coffee. Everything that could go wrong did. But you know what? I'm here with you guys, so I'm happy.
Yeah.
Happy, what's new, Grace?
And look at us. We are here to lighten your day, dressed all in black, both of us.
Well, I am wearing flowers.
We are
I am wearing flowers.
You.
So, what's new? What's going on?
Honestly, just a lot of wedding planning on my end.
It's coming down to the wire.
Yeah, it is. And I need to figure out what the hell I am wearing. I have it like mostly down. I have like the pants down, which I feel like was a big battle. But as far as like what, you know, you have to decide, like, is it gonna be a floral arrangement on like on the neck region or on the boob region or like where, or a bolo tie or a bow tie, but I don't wanna do a
bow
tie.
Don't do a bolo tie, don't do that.
Just, but Will, it's easy, like, it's easy to say no, it's harder to say yes. Like, you know what you don't want.
What is that?
You know what I mean? No, I mean, like, when it comes to like style, usually you have this like knee-jerk reaction, it's like, I don't like that, but it's harder when you're trying something new to be like, but do I like that? Like, is that me? Especially for formal occasions, I never dress up. You look great all the time.
So what have you decided you're going to wear?
I don't know, Will. You'll have to come back for another show and I'll tell you.
Next week.
I mean, you've been slimming down. You've been like preparing. So whatever you come up with is going to be fantastic. Will Neff on the show. Hi, Will.
Hi.
I love that.
What do you have to share?
Yeah, what do you have to share before we get started?
I don't know. I've just been living my life, just doing my thing, trying to get rid of all my winter weight.
Winter, stop it.
I get pretty fat every winter.
Troll his Instagram and you will see nothing but body karate.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Those are Photoshopped.
I mean, hey, listen, go hard or go home. We have a fantastic show today, you guys. Seth MacFarlane has called out Fox News for their biased, insensitive, and very delusional coverage of what's going on at the US-Mexican border. Now, since April of this year, Trump has enacted a zero tolerance policy, which is essentially detaining people at the border and stripping parents away from their kids. Now, as we've gone to tape today, more than 2,300 children and youths are either separated from their parents and their families or missing. And I have no words to describe how frustrating and how disheartening this is. Seth MacFarlane has taken to his Twitter to voice his disgust, literal disgust, along with other Fox talents in regards to the situation. You guys, when you read this, or when you heard that Seth MacFarlane went on Twitter, what did you think? Because Seth MacFarlane has had an overall deal with Fox since damn near 20 years now, Family Guy, what other shows he's done.
American Dad.
Orville, exactly, yeah.
I wasn't too surprised. I think he's been very vocal on Twitter with regards to his disillusion with this administration, and he's been criticizing them significantly on Twitter. I think that it is encouraging because Judd Apatow, I believe, pointed out that this is a harder thing to do just for everyone that works at Fox. You can't expect for the PAs and everything to be like, I'm not going to be affiliated with Fox. But you can expect that for people in positions of great power. And Seth MacFarlane is one of those people. So I wasn't too surprised because he has, for lack of a better word, clout with Fox, and they are going to listen to him. So, and also he's already voiced his opinions on a lot of what's going on right now politically. So I wasn't too surprised, and it'll be interesting to see who else steps up from Fox.
Well, Steve Levitin, who also is the showrunner and producer of Modern Family, also came to the forefront to talk about his opinions as well. Now, they both have overall deals that are expiring this year and next year, and there's a looming sale of Fox to either Disney or Comcast. So the timing's really favorable for these kinds of things, but other stars have now come to the forefront to voice their opinion. You have Brad Falchuk and Ryan Murphy, who are the masterminds behind Nip Tuck, Glee, all the FX shows. Kurt Sutter of The Mayans, Alex Ganzen, Howard Gordon of Homeland, and also Al Jean from The Simpsons. Will, what's up?
I respect this kind of activism a lot more than what I saw of like a Robert De Niro who just gets up and is like, Trump. This seems like this is very pointed, and a lot of these creators have given an ultimatum, right? Like the creator of Modern Family said, I want to consider my own family just not here anymore.
Right.
I'm picking up sticks, I'm moving. And I think you're much more likely to see a positive reaction out of Fox when you hit them in their pocketbook, right? I think that's like the good aspect of late stage capitalism, where it's like when a major company like Fox starts taking losses, when they lose a MacFarlane, when they lose a Modern Family, they might go, hey, we really need to tone down this crazy we're doing on our news network.
Do you think that we will see some sort of reaction from Fox? Because it also seems like we're talking about a major,
right,
major news behemoth and just media conglomerate company in general. It's easy, yeah, for us to be like, wow, it's Seth MacFarlane. Like, how could they not listen? But then we're talking about pennies to them, basically. Sometimes I wonder, is it really significant? Are they going to, right, make a change?
Well, what I've seen is already people are trying to distance Fox Entertainment from Fox News,
right,
which is, right, kind of a unusual thing because you know this is all like Rupert Murdoch's unholy, you know, amalgam of media networks.
Right.
So it's funny because this is a call forward. We'll transition to Dunkin' Donuts in that like one employee is doing something wrong. Is that an indictment of the whole company?
Well, Steve, right, that's a great question. Steve Levitin actually answers that question saying that he has very great relationships with execs on the talent, right, arm of Fox. And he actually gave an update and a clarification to his statement and his tweet. He says, for now, I will take some time to see where these people land. And at that point, I will make a decision about my future. So what he's talking about there is if he chooses to continue with Fox,
yeah,
with you saying that the entertainment is not at fault, but mainly the news side.
Right.
Then we'll see where that happens.
But I do think that Fox News is now at a breaking point.
Right.
Now, where for so long we've kind of questioned, all right, how far is this going to go? How editorialized, how kind of insane is Fox News going to get? You know, there's been all these gags. It's like, are we going to see like destruction derby on Fox, yeah, News? And I think you're there, right? You now have the Womp Womp incident today. You have you basically just have their pundits running amok. And I think this is the breaking point.
I want to bring up breaking news, which comes from the Trump administration. Donald Trump has signed this morning an executive order, which is effectively ending family separations at the U.S.-Mexico border. This is a developing story, but what we know right now is that the plan, as described by the administration officials, would keep families together in federal custody while they are awaiting prosecution. So they're not actually going to be ending the zero tolerance policy, just keeping families together if they are crossing the border illegally. This is potentially, though, and keep an eye on this, violating a 1997 court settlement limiting the duration of child detention. So again, a developing story. It's going to be interesting to see how, yeah, different media outlets cover this.
Yeah.
It's going to be interesting to see how this is rolled out.
Also, Seth MacFarlane, great news there. Seth MacFarlane is also putting his money where his mouth is. Sorry, he's donating $2 million to NPR, which is indie media, and $500,000 to LA's NPR membership station, KPCC, here in Southern California, because he is completely done with corporate media. So this is awesome. Hey, progress is progress, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not holding my breath on this, Grace, but hopefully the Trump administration can get it together.
The one thing I'm worried about is that this might become like a bump stock. Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead.
No, you're good.
In that, like, they give us something, right? They're like, oh, we're putting families back together. But the origin of it is that they're going to do something so horrible that everyone gets up in arms about. They make this little concession, and then everyone forgets about it, and we're still terrible to our immigrants. Sorry.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay, great. Well, there you guys have it. Yeah, I mean, hopefully we can get these kids reunited with their families.